I want you to put down a piece of paper and I want you to make a list of every single person you know. Friend, family, network, acquaintance, that's a business owner. Then what I'm gonna have you do is I'm gonna have you reach out to them. Literally all you say, you can write this down right now. Hey, first name. So you say, hey, Bill, thought of you today, period. Are you free to talk later today or tomorrow? Send a message to them, right? Get them on a phone. When you get on that conversation, you want to see what's up. What's going on for the year? How's business been going? Are they having any problems relating to their tax situation, relating to their accounting, relating to their finances, relating to their money, relating to profitability, relating to the people that are working for them that are doing accounting, that are doing taxes? Are they having any problems? And if they're having any problems, you have to make them an offer. You have to give them a price. And you have to ask them if they want to work with you. Your success in business is directly related to the number of people that you have an appointment with. Number one, have an appointment with. And number two, make an offer to. Okay, that's the other piece. You have to make an offer. So you actually have to give them a price and ask them if they're ready to go. You cannot avoid this. You cannot avoid this. And I had a moment, you know, a couple of years ago when I was in, like I said, 4 or 5 years ago, when I made this decision myself. And I had this realization that if every single day, all I did was get up, try to reach out to as many people as I could, do as many appointments as I could. And every single call, I had to give myself a rule. 100% of the calls I would give price because I was so nervous, right? I was so nervous to like do a sales consultation. I remember I told my wife at one point, I said, sales is stupid. You know, you do 4 or 5 meetings, you only get one client. It seems like a big waste of time. And so I didn't do it for a long time. But when I finally realized, gosh, if I don't talk to people and ask them if they want to work with me, I'm not going to be where I want to be. And so I had this realization. And so I stopped everything that I was doing. I was supposed to take a contract job because I couldn't get my business off the ground. I said, I'm not going to take the contract job. I'm going to reach out to as many people as I can. And every single day, if I go out there, if I reach out to people, I do appointments, I see what their problems are, I make them an offer, I give them a price, someone in a moment of desperation is going to say yes to me. And I made that decision to make sales a priority, to make the top line growth of my business, to make revenue a priority. And most people never make that decision. They're in business, right? They're doing things, they're doing accounting, they're helping clients, but they never make the decision to be a great salesman or to be a great saleswoman or to increase their pricing, to make it a priority. From that moment, right? That was in a month of November or December. It was only about 5 months until I broke 100,000 in sales. I remember from that moment, it wasn't like it happened instantly. I mean, 4 or 5 months is pretty fast, but we were still staying in these crappy little places. And I remember I was staying in this hotel. It was an Airbnb. And it was a little shitty one bedroom apartment, terrible setup. But every day I got up, I wore a little jacket like this to put myself in a good frame of mind. I got up, I did my hair, and I went to go sit at this really small little table. And I reached out to people. I did appointments. I saw if I could help them. And I committed to doing that every single day. And I remember there was one day where I got two clients. And I got two clients, and I think I ended up collecting up front from those two clients $9,000 in cash in one day. And when that happened, I had, at the time, I had on my phone little notifications every time we get payments. Now, I mean, that would be absolutely insane. Our company has grown so big. But at the time, it wasn't, you know, I would get a couple of transactions a week, I'd hope, right? So I wanted to see them and get the notifications. And I had two transactions come through my phone, and it added up to $9,000 for clients that were signing on to work with me. And I sent those over to my wife, and she was traveling. And it was really in that moment that I realized that I had, I don't want to say made it, but that because I had made sales a priority, I knew I could create wealth for myself. I knew I could create wealth for my business. I knew I could go out to the small business market in America and get clients on my own will, on my own volition. There's all sorts of excuses that you're going to make, right? Like I had this guy last night that I had him go through this process, make a list, friends, family, network, and acquaintances, go through and reach out to them. I asked him, I said, what's the percentage likelihood? I made him send one with me on the call. And I said, what's the percentage likelihood that you're going to reach out to another 19 people by tomorrow at noon? And I'm going to ask you that same thing. What is the percentage likelihood that you're going to reach out to 20 people today? What is it? What's the percentage? If you can't Facebook message, text message, email 20 people, do you have any idea how much harder other things that you're gonna have to do to be successful at growing your company, getting sales, closing deals, getting appointments, getting clients. There's a lot more things that are a hell of a lot more complicated. If you can't sell somebody you know, you're never gonna sell somebody you don't know. Everybody says, I just wanna go to strangers. I wanna go outside of my city. I hear you. But if you're broke, or if you're not consistently getting clients, or if you're not at 100,000 in sales, or if you haven't been growing for a few years, you don't have the luxury. You need to do whatever you need to do to make it work. And if you're watching this today and you go around, you say to yourself, I want to grow my business, but you're not willing to do what I told you here today, to just reach out to some people that you know to see if you can help them, right? You don't need to sell somebody something if you can't help them. But when you go out there and you see what's going on for these people, there are problems. There are problems that these people are having. And because you're not out there talking to them, they're still in pain. You have to take responsibility for your own business. You have to take responsibility for getting your sales to a certain level, especially if you're less than $1 million a year in sales. You're gonna be very involved in the sales process if you're doing less than $1 million a year in sales. And so have you decided that sales is a priority? Have you decided that you're gonna reach out to every single person you possibly can? And have you decided that you're gonna give every single person that you can a price, an offer? If you've decided those three things, it is unbelievable how quickly your life can change. 20 friends, family, network, and acquaintances, reach out to them with that message earlier. If you want accountingtax.com/enroll, I'm giving you a script, 4 hours. So that's the other piece, right? If I have you reach out to these people, what are you gonna say to them? The script, I put in here, accountingtax.com/enroll, 4.2 hours of a tax planning script where you'll be able to sit down across from that business owner and you'll be able to tell them exactly how much they overpaid, or an estimate of what they overpaid in taxes last year, an estimate of what they're on track to overpay this year. I'm giving you 4 hours of training for free. I'm giving you a 90-page sales script. So what's the excuse now? What's the excuse now? You reach out and you're gonna say, well, I wanna go through the script first before I reach out to them. Wrong. You can't do that. You need to reach out to them first, get them on the calendar, get the appointment. I tell you, that's gonna be a really good motivation to go through that script. It's 4 hours of training, you go through it quick. If you have a meeting tomorrow at 10 a.m., that is gonna be the best motivation to get through 4 hours of training between now and the end of the night. You're gonna skip Stranger Things 3 or whatever the hell's on Netflix right now, and you're gonna get through that script. So reach out to these people first, accountingtax.com/enroll, go through the script, get on the phone, and freaking help somebody out today.